Hello dear students, I am Sangeeta Ghosh and along with my team members once again bring to you this session of questions and answers to the PU Board Question Bank. For this unit, according to the question paper pattern, relevant and important questions for this unit of microeconomics, theory of consumer behavior is being discussed. Kindly make a note of all the important points and answers for your preparations of this unit. Before we proceed, kindly go through the disclaimer. This session has been prepared for the benefit of ASC Commerce College students. Kindly read the disclaimer. So, I assume that you have heard and gone through the second unit of microeconomics, theory of consumer behavior, completely. Now we shall come to the part of analyzing how well you have understood the concepts explained to you. Kindly follow certain instructions which I will give to you carefully. Kindly keep your copy of the question bank along with you. Keep the notebook ready with you and note down the points discussed and the answers given. After every video session, kindly summarize what you have learned from it briefly and write it down in a notebook for submission as assignments when we reopen. In this session, therefore, students, I'll make an attempt to explain to you the answers to the questions. I expect you to understand and revise them for better clarity, and so we shall start. You know that economics question paper pattern is divided into 5 parts: A, B, C, D, and E. I'll begin my discussion of part A, which is further subdivided into different sections for 1 mark each. The first classification of part A questions is the multiple choice questions. Before I discuss and tell you the answers, try to note down the correct answer and so that you can then tally which was the actual correct answer. The questions given are as follows. Utility is, you have options, objective, subjective, both A and B, and none of these. Second, the shape of an indifference curve is normally convex to origin, concave to origin, horizontal, or vertical. Thirdly, the consumption bundles that are available to the consumer depend on color and shape, price and income, income and quality, and none. Fourth, the equation of the budget line. You are having 4 options in this: A, B, C, D. Fifth, the demand for these goods increases as income increases. Options A, B, C, D: inferior goods, Giffen goods, normal goods, none of the above. Sixth, a vertical demand curve is A, B, C, D. Options perfectly elastic, perfectly inelastic, unitary elastic, none of the above. 7. Ordinal utility analysis expresses utility in A, B, C, D options, numbers, returns, ranks, awards. I shall now tell you the correct answers. You have made already a choice. Now let's see if you have got it right. The first one, utility is subjective, which means utility differs from person to person. Suppose if a person loves to eat mangoes, it has utility for him. But if someone doesn't like it, there is no utility of that mango for such a consumer. It is a feature of utility. Second, the answer is convex to the origin. In physics, we have two types of lenses, convex and concave. The origin of the graph is the vertex of the graph. So when an indifference curve is drawn, it will always be convex to the origin. Third, the answer is price and income. The consumption bundles that are available to the consumer depend upon its price and the income of the consumer. The consumer will make a choice of the quantity of the commodity. He would buy it depending on the price of the commodity. If the price is high, he will buy less. If the price is less, he will buy more. Whether he'll buy a commodity and how much of it he'll buy will also depend upon his income, which is a constraining factor. Fourth, the equation of the budget line is option C. P1x1 plus P2x2 is equal to M. M is the income of the consumer, which is a constraint. Whatever the consumer purchases, it has to be within that limitation. We assume this as the resource. Now, consumer spends his income to buy different goods. Let us assume there are only two goods, like rice and wheat, or mangoes and oranges, etc. The consumer will make a choice between the two goods based on what amount of utility he derives by consuming it and what is its price. Fifth, normal goods. This is the effect of income on the demand for the goods. When a consumer's income increases, the consumer would prefer to buy more of the normal goods, which are better in quality, and would therefore buy less of the inferior goods. Example, if you have 100 rupees with you, then you will buy for yourself very simple food to eat. But if you have 500 rupees or 1000 rupees, then you will definitely buy better quality food for yourself. Sixth, the answer is perfectly inelastic. A vertical demand curve is a straight line on the x-axis. In such a condition, the quantity demanded for a commodity remains the same at whatever price of the commodity, regardless of it being less or more. The seventh answer is ranks. In real life, utility is not expressed in any form of numbers. The consumer can only rank utility according to ranks. For example, if we consider fruits and analyze the utility of fruits for the consumer, then mangoes may be the first preference, followed by oranges, and then the consumer may prefer watermelon, apples, and bananas. So these fruits can be ranked respectively as mangoes, oranges, watermelons, apples, and bananas as ranks from 1 to 5. This kind of analysis is ordinal utility analysis. I hope the concept is now clear with respect to the multiple choice questions. And now we move on to the next section. Now, the second section of part A is the fill in the blanks. Read the fill in the blanks carefully and let's see if you know the answers to them. One satisfying capacity of a commodity is two indifference curve never dash each other. As income increases, the demand curve for normal goods shifts towards. The demand for a good moves in the dash direction of its price. Method of adding to individual demand curve is called dash. Let us now see what are the answers for the fill in the blanks. The first one was want satisfying capacity of a commodity is, and the answer is utility. Second one, two indifference curve never intersect each other because the indifference curves will always move higher rightwards or lower leftwards. If they intersect, it will give absurd result because for both the indifference curves, there will then be a common combination, which is not possible. Third, as income increases, the demand curve for the normal goods shifts towards the right. So the answer is rightwards. If income increases, then the consumer will purchase more of the commodity according to the prevailing prices. Fourth, the demand for a good moves in the opposite direction of its price. The increase of price brings a reduction in the quantity demanded, and the decrease of price brings an increase in the quantity demanded. So, demand curve is downward sloping, therefore it moves in the opposite direction to its price. The method of adding two individual demand curves is called as horizontal summation. At price 10, if the quantity demanded for A is 30 and for B it is 20, summing it up would mean adding up the demand for both the individuals. So 30 plus 20 would be 50. This is what is horizontal summation of the demand. I hope now, students, you have got the answers for the fill in the blanks. So we now shall move on to the next part. So students, we have now come to the next part of the questions for 1 mark, which is the match the following. Kindly go through both the columns A and B. Carefully observe how you need to answer the match the following. You need to write the complete sentence and not write it just as numbers matched with the columns like 1 with B, C, D, etc. Kindly observe in the next slide how you have to write the answers. This particular question must be written as you find it in the slide. Kindly make a note of the answers, students, and see how it is written. For example, the first answer is demand curve is a downward sloping curve, and continue to answer the rest also in the similar pattern. Have a look and note down. So we now come to the next section of part A, again for 1 mark each, which is in the form of question and answers. This must be answered as follows. The questions are, what is a budget line? What do you mean by cardinal utility analysis? Give the meaning of marginal utility. What is utility? Expand MRS. What do you mean by indifference curve? And what is demand? The answer for the first question is, the budget line is a locus of different combinations of two commodities which the consumer consumes and whose cost is exactly equal to his income. Secondly, the cardinal utility analysis refers to the method where the utility can be measured with the help of cardinal numbers such as 1, 2, 3, etc. It refers to those numbers that can be added, subtracted, or multiplied. Third answer, marginal utility is the change in the total utility due to consumption of one additional unit of a commodity. Fourthly, utility means want satisfying power of a good or service. I shall continue the answers for the rest in the next slide. Continuing the 1 mark questions, the answer to the next question, expansion of MRS is marginal rate of substitution. The indifference curve shows different combinations of two commodities in which the consumer gets equal level of satisfaction. And the last answer, demand refers to the quantity of a good that a consumer purchases in a market at a particular price at a particular time. We shall now discuss the answers for the next section, section B. For this chapter, from the PU Board Question Bank. The questions are as follows. What is the difference between budget line and budget set? What do you mean by inferior goods? Give example. What is monotonic preference? State the law of demand. Mention two different approaches which explain the consumer's behavior. And what do you mean by price elasticity of demand? I shall now discuss the answers for you It is there on the slide for you to see. Kindly note down the answers. Budget set is the collection of all bundles that the consumer can buy with the income at the prevailing market price. Budget line consists of all the bundles which cost exactly equal to the money. Inferior goods are goods for which the demand is inversely variable to the consumer's income. As the income increases, its demand decreases and vice versa. Monotonic preference. A rational consumer prefers more of the commodity that offers him a higher level of satisfaction. Hence, it is called monotonic preference. I shall continue the next answers in the next slide. Continuing our answers for the 2 marks questions of section B. The law of demand states that other things remaining constant, ceteris paribus, where the price of a good decreases, the quantity demanded for the good increases, and when the price increases, the quantity demanded decreases for the good. The indifference approaches which explain the consumer behavior are cardinal utility analysis and ordinal utility analysis. The price elasticity of demand is a measure of the responsiveness of the demand for the good to a change in the price. It means the amount of change in the quantity demanded with respect to a certain price change. Kindly look at the formula of how it is calculated and note it down. So now students, you have noted the answers for part A for 1 mark and part B of 2 marks. It is now the third section, which is for 4 marks, and this part is part C. The questions are as follows. Write the differences between total and marginal utility. Explain the indifference map with a diagram. Briefly explain the budget set with the help of a diagram. Explain the derivation of the slope of the budget line. Write the differences between substitutes and complements. Explain the differences between normal and inferior goods with examples. Let us now see what is the difference between total utility and marginal utility. Utility, you know, is the want satisfying capacity of a commodity. When I drink the first cup of tea, I would be ready to pay 10 rupees. And for a second consecutive tea, I may pay 8 rupees. And for the third, 5 rupees. Now, the total utility is the added up utility of all the 3 cups of tea that I had. Let us see what the answer is. Total utility is the total satisfaction derived from consuming the given amount of any commodity X. More of the commodity provides more satisfaction to the consumer. It depends on the quantity of the commodity used. Total utility is equal to the total of the marginal utility of all the quantities consumed. Whereas marginal utility is the change in the total utility due to the consumption of one additional unit of the commodity. It depends upon the number of additional units of the commodity which has been consumed. Kindly note the answer. You know that indifference curve is the consumer's preferences at different levels of income. A set of all indifference curves is called as indifference map. Kindly look at the figure provided and note down the answer. The consumers will have different preferences over all the bundles, which is represented by a family of indifference curves, which is called as indifference map. The bundles on the higher indifference curve are preferred by the consumers as it gives higher satisfaction. The consumers get higher satisfaction than on the lower indifference curve. So, the higher indifference curve is preferred more. The next question is about the budget set. The consumer has a constraint of income. If we assume that there are only two goods available, then the consumer will have to make a choice between the two by choosing one good more than the other based on their prices and the utility that the good has. This set of different choices that the consumer makes is a collection of different types of substitutions that the consumer makes. It is a collection of bundles which is called as the budget set. The budget set, therefore, is a collection of all the bundles that the consumer can buy with their income at the given prices. Suppose the income of a consumer is M or 100. The two things that he can buy, let us assume, are oranges and mangoes. And let the prices of the oranges and mangoes be P1 and P2. The consumer has a certain preference and utility for both the commodities and will make a choice between both based on their prices and their utility. Now, when this choice is made, it will be based on the limitation of his income. So, he will spend P1 X1 plus P2 X2 amount of money. I am continuing the answer for the budget set with the diagram. Note down the diagram. A similar set of choices available to the consumer where he chooses more of any one good and less of the other is called as the budget set. Look at the various bundles that is available to him, A, B, C, D and E, and combinations of oranges and mangoes when price of both the commodities is rupees 5. Assuming that the price is 5 rupees for both, let us see the various combinations that the consumer can buy. If he purchases 0 oranges, he can buy 4 mangoes, or 1 orange with a combination of 3 mangoes. Likewise, he may buy an equal quantity of both, 2 oranges and 2 mangoes, or 3 oranges and 1 mango and 4 oranges or none of the mangoes. Assuming that his income is rupees 20. Let us now look at the explanation of the derivation of the slope of a budget line. The slope of the budget line measures the amount of change in one good, example mangoes, required per unit of change in the units of another good, example oranges. The slope consists of all the bundles which will cost exactly equal to M, which is the income of the consumer. Any point below the line will cost less than M, and any point above it will cost more than M. The horizontal intercept M by P1 is where entire income is spent on only one good, mangoes. Likewise, the vertical intercept M bar P2 is when entire income is spent on the other good, oranges. The slope of the combination of the quantities bought is P1x1 plus P2x2, which is equal to M. Kindly look at the diagram in the next slide for the budget line. This is the continuation of the diagram for the slope of the budget line. Kindly make a note. According to the example of the limitation of income, let us assume that to be rupees 20, the different combinations available to the consumer may be the different bundles A, B, C, D and E, and the two commodities that he can buy are either mangoes or oranges in different combinations. The next question is the differences between substitute goods and complement goods. Note down the difference. Substitutes are goods which are used as alternatives to satisfy a particular need, example tea or coffee. They are not used together, but any one of them is consumed. The demand for them is affected by the price of the other. If their price increases, the demand for the good decreases, and vice versa. Complementary goods are goods which are consumed together, like tea and sugar, pen and ink, bike and petrol. These goods are paired and consumed together. The increase in the price of one will bring down the demand for the complementary good. The sixth question, the differences between normal goods and inferior goods, is as follows. Kindly note. Normal goods are goods for which the consumer's demand increases as the consumer's income increases, and the demand decreases as the income decreases. Daily use goods, groceries, vegetables and fruits, clothes, etc. are examples of normal goods. Demand moves in the same direction as the income of the consumer. Inferior goods are goods for which the consumer's demand decreases as their income increases and the demand increases as the income decreases. These are goods like inferior millets, cosmetics, etc. The demand for inferior goods moves in opposite direction to the income of the consumer. Students, now it is the next section, which is section D, for 6 marks question and answers. Here I'll give you certain points for each of the answers. Note down the points and based on the points develop the complete answer and write them down in the notebooks to be submitted to your respective teachers when we associate again for the classes. I'm sure based on what you have learned so far, you will be able to do it. The first question is regarding the law of diminishing marginal utility. The question is, explain the law of diminishing marginal utility with the help of a table and a diagram. Kindly note that you need to first write the meaning of the law of diminishing marginal utility, which means you mention the law and then you give an example, table it, and also draw a diagram for the table that you draw, and then give it a conclusion. For example, I have given to you a table. What I shall explain now, one of the examples. If a girl is very thirsty and comes home and drinks the first glass of water, it will have a lot of utility for her. Immediately, if she has to drink the second glass of water, the extent of thirst is reduced, so the second glass has less utility. Likewise, the third glass of water which she will drink will have very less utility. Thus, additional utility goes on decreasing on the consumption of more and more units of the commodity. It may go down to zero and even decline further. Such an example can be given. You may use any other example which you feel like and make a note of it in the form of a table, schedule it, and then plot it over the graph. You will find that in the graph, the marginal utility will be decreasing. The next question is explanation of the features of indifference curve with the help of diagrams. I have provided for you the diagrams on the right hand side of the slide. Kindly make a note of the diagrams which explain the features of the indifference curve which can be used during the explanations. When you write the features of the indifference curve, you first begin with the meaning of the indifference curve. Then note down the features, the first feature being a higher indifference curve represents higher satisfaction than the lower indifference curve. Explain the point. Second, the indifference curves are downward sloping. Indifference curve do not intersect each other, and indifference curve will always be convex to the origin and not concave. You can use the diagrams provided to explain the concept and then give it a conclusion. The next question is explaining the optimal choice of the consumer with the help of a diagram. The optimal choice of the consumer depends upon the indifference curve, which shows the priority and the choice of the consumer, and the budget line, which shows the ability to pay. The choice and the priority of the consumer depends upon the affordability. So, indifference curves are combined with the budget line to determine the combination of the goods that can be purchased within a budget. The assumptions are that the income of the consumer is given, the consumer is rational, the price of the goods and services are constant, and all goods are homogeneous and divisible, and the consumer prefers more of one commodity over the other. The diagram is provided to you on the right hand side. Kindly make a note of these key points to frame the answer for this question. The next question is explaining the movement along the demand curve and the shift in the demand curve. The movement along the demand curve depends upon the price of the good, and the other factors remain constant. Demand curve represents it. At higher prices, consumer buys less quantities and vice versa. The shift in the demand curve happens when other factors affecting demand change and the price remains constant. If the income of the consumer increases, the taste and preferences become favorable, the demand increases and shifts rightwards, and vice versa. You can make use of the diagrams provided to you in the next slide regarding the movement along the demand curve and the shifts in the demand curve, which you can use to frame the answer. Have a look at the diagrams. The diagram on the left shows the movement along the demand curve, the responses of the consumer to the different prices in making a choice of different quantities of goods. Towards your right hand side, you have the two diagrams which show the rightward movement of the demand curve and the leftward movement of the demand curve, the shifts in the demand curve when the income of the consumer increases or decreases, and the taste and preferences of the consumer become favorable or unfavorable. Use these diagrams to explain your answer. We now look at the last answer for market demand. Individual consumers have quantities of demand at different price. Market comprises of many consumers. Market demand for a good at a price is the total demand for all the consumers put together. Imagine that there are two consumers. Market demand is derived by adding up the demand of the two consumers at the given price. Similarly, all consumers' demand is added, which makes up the market demand. The market demand is derived as a horizontal summation of the individual demand curves. Have a look at the diagram, which will help you to explain the points. These are the diagrams. In the first figure, let us assume it is a demand curve of one individual A. The second figure, let us assume it is the demand curve of another individual B. Totaling up both A and B makes up the summation of both their demands. The third figure represents the demand curve of both A as well as B, which is called as horizontal summation of the individual demand curves. You can use this to explain the market demand. I hope, students, the sessions in total have been useful and helpful to you in understanding the concept of the theory of consumer behavior. Kindly go through the chapter and make a note of what you have understood. All the best. Thank you.